Locked, at home or in digital world? The world was hard hit by the corona pandemic. Although the silver lining is that happy people have time to spend with their loved ones in their homes, worldwide telecommunications operators have seen data usage increase. A friend shared her regular schedule during this lockdown on a video call with some of my friends. She followed a basic routine: wake up, check social media and messenger, eat, get online for office work, and check social media and messenger again, eat, watch Netflix, do office work again, sleep and repeat. After 20 days of lockdown and the same routine, she had serious neck and shoulder pain. Her eyes have become dry due to overexposure of digital displays. Most people are either stuck in their phones all day or juggling between various digital devices and household jobs. This made me realize that along with the fear of coronavirus, the ongoing use of technology is another aspect that affects our lives during those days. It is true that technology has changed our lives by bringing comfort and stability to our jobs, but it does not stop because of it, always on. Constant use of new age technologies along with staying at home gives rise to a lot of problems such as anxiety, frustration, low mood, depression, frustration, irritability, headache, back and neck pain, bad sleep quality, reduced attention span, just to name a few. Although the social distance is an hour, so it is necessary to conform to these guidelines, we must always remember how we spend our time at home, as the long-term effect of increased visual noise can be irreversible. Some disturbing things to ponder upon: the amount of time spent on email has risen by 17%, 31%, and 36% during the lockdown in Canada. Instant messengers, obviously, 76% of the total number of likes accumulated on hash ad posts of their own Instagram campaigns, and 27% of the jump in TikTok lockdown is up by 76%. Digital eye pressure cuts our light rate by half, and almost 60% of U.S. adults are affected by it. About 40% of mobile bedside users wake up from noise or lighting alerts on their smartphones. Our attention span has been reduced from 12 minutes to 5 minutes with the continuous use of technology. Aren't these things scary? Let's stop for a second and ask about where we're heading. Digital well-being, digital detox, digital minimalism, different terms for the same stuff are the solution to these technology-related issues. All these are the same slogan: thoughtful and considerate use of technology only where it is necessary. Digital minimalism, as described by popular author Cal Newport, is a philosophy that makes you doubt what digital communication devices and behaviors surrounding these tools bring the most value to your life. It is driven by the idea that consciously and actively clearing away low-value digital clutter, and maximizing the use of the resources that really matter, will enhance life dramatically. Digital minimalism is important to be in the present moment, in our house with people around us, not only emotionally but mentally, enjoy the long-lost interests that remain in our resumes and slam books, let our brains participate in something meaningful and grow imagination inside us. Most specifically, to get our lives back from the artificial world, live again, and not become internet slaves without knowing it. There is no time or day to start discussing the correct use of technology, the earlier the better. However, despite the latest pandemic and lockdown situation, isn't it the only friend possible 24/7 in the world? And are we meant to talk about all this now? The response is an undisputed yes, as overuse of technology at this time of depression and exhaustion of work, office and home both, would have a significant effect on our bodies, mind and soul. We're hoping to get rid of corona early, but maybe we're stuck in another lifelong lifestyle issue. Here are a few simple steps to continue during the lockdown screen hygiene: wipe the keypads, keyboards and frequently wash the computer gadgets with dilute soap water, set boundaries, fix your job and home, telephone, email time, check your emails 2 or 3 times a day, and for the remainder of your work time, you can concentrate on the actual work and remain productive. Fix your screen time, examine how much time you spend on all digital devices on a day, and start adjusting your overall screen time to 1 or 2 less than the current one. Then slowly the screen time to meet the goal. Plan your day, decide when you want, need to sign on and sign off. Screen time must also be classified by the devices, for e.g. 1.5 hours a day for mobile devices, 6 slots of 15 minutes every 2 hours between 10 a.m. and 8 p.m. Schedule the computer time, fix the time you spent on and task or app, e.g. 15 minutes for social media, 20 minutes for emails, 30 minutes for calls, etc. You will configure timers for your applications on most Android digital well-being and iOS devices. Unclutter, remove all unwanted settings, folders, videos, podcasts, etc. This will help you save any space in your system as well as in your mind. Silence, please switch off all voice, light, and vibration feedback devices aside from calls. Not every beep the system gives is important and does not deserve the urgent attention. Remember, we're not thinking of complete disconnection from technology, because that is neither suggested nor possible. We're only thinking about its active, deliberate, reflective application, instead of the normal one. Moreover, there's not going to be a better moment than today, because the infection dissemination lockdown has given us time to talk about ourselves again. Last but not least, technology will never take priority over people, close family, friends you're living with at this moment. We need to understand how to find a balance between real life and virtual reality. As Sierra, an American musician, rightly said, "This digital world is what you make it in the end."